Good morning. It's a beautiful day. And today's about our hearts. The heart. You know, it's so intricately aligned with the lungs. And it's interesting that the heart, actually the blood that the heart pumps, represents about 1/10 of our weight. But that's not how you want to lose weight, by giving blood. And of course, the blood requires hydration for proper viscosity and proper blood pressure. Now, it may be counterintuitive to think about the lungs requiring hydration, but if they're not moist, you don't get rid, you can't receive oxygen, the lungs can't receive the oxygen, and they can't let go of the carbon dioxide. And I want to say right now, because I talk about how important exhalation is. The body naturally, when there's a vacuum, and it will breathe in, but we don't do a good job of exhaling and letting go. The importance of getting rid of carbon dioxide is because it can actually stimulate your adrenals to release cortisol and adrenaline, which makes more inflammation, more acidity in the body. It's not a small thing. And the thing about coming to yoga or practicing yoga or doing any form of exercise, whether walking, swimming, I mean, the more different things we do, the better. But yoga, in my opinion, is still one of the best, is that it will stimulate respiration, but the heart is involved in the whole program. So today is all about the heart taking center stage. Now, all cardiologists pretty much know now the benefits of doing yoga. It's a great stress releaser. It relaxes the body, particularly, and I want us when we practice today to really focus on our breathing for the reasons that I just said, but also too, it relaxes the body, it relaxes the mind. And when we focus on what we're doing, we don't judge what we're doing, we just do it and we do our best. And I think everybody is doing that from what I can see. So we're going to start with cardio. So come on to a standing, up to a standing posture. And what we're going to practice first is 4 rounds of sun salutations. Not a lot, but it's more than what we would typically do. But we want to get our heart warmed up. We want to get it going. And then, of course, we're going to do a little bit of a vinyasa after that, and then we'll come down onto our mats and relax. So this idea of strengthening the heart, getting it pumping blood. Remember, your red blood cells carry oxygen. Your white blood cells are intimately connected with your immune system. You want all of that stuff all over your body. So wherever you're ailing, aching, need to heal, getting the heart pumping the blood, super important. Of course, the nutrients too. We're going to talk about diet. So come on up to the fronts of your mats. Maybe we'll put a little, see if this thing's still happening. Okay. I should have more lively music, but hey, can't do it all at once. So inhaling in place, exhale, hands in prayer. Step your feet apart. Arms up, reach up, look up, and arc back. Inhale, stretching up. Exhale, forward fold. Now, we're still warming up the body, so don't worry about getting this just all perfect. Step your left leg back and place your hands on your front right thigh. Inhale, lift that back knee off the floor. Press through your heel. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, turn your hands forward. Bring them to the mat, step your front leg back. So we're in plank position here, but remember, you can always lower your knees. Please protect your wrists and your shoulders if these are issues. If you're in plank position, engage your core, reach the crown of your head forward, feel the stretch on the bottoms of your feet, your plantar fascia, and then bring your knees to the floor, flatten the tops of your feet, take your hips back towards your heels, stretching the chest, stretching the shoulders. We stretch the heart in yoga and we work it. And then release your forearms and elbows to the floor. Slowly come forward, bringing chest, chin to the floor. Slide everything out behind you. Align your fingertips with the edges of your shoulders. Roll an invisible alley with your nose, lengthening your neck. On an inhale, without using your hands, lift up, stretching the heart as we work it. Holding, exhale, lengthen as you lower. Curl your toes under, lift your hips up. Walk your feet a few inches forward, bend your knees, press your belly onto your thighs, align your ears with your inner arms and press all those fingertips into the floor. On an exhale, press your sits bones towards the back of your mat and press your heels towards the floor. Feel the stretch, feel the energy flowing through your body. Lift your left leg up in the air, look at your left hand and swing that foot as far forward as you can. Other leg forward, and please let your upper body hang in Uttanasana. Arms beside your ears, engage your thighs, pull your bellies in, inhale, sweep the arms up, feet apart for balance, reach up, look up, arc back. Inhaling, stretch up, exhale, forward fold, bend your knees, inhale, sweep the arms up, hands in prayer to your heart center, Anjali Mudra. Second round, inhale, exhale, hands in prayer, feet apart, reach up, look up, arc back. Don't do too much, don't do too little. Inhale, feet come back together, lift up out of your waist, hinge from your hips as you fold forward into Uttanasana. Fingertips touch the floor, step your right leg back, drop the knee to the mat, bring your hands onto your left thigh. Focus your gaze for balance as you lift the back knee off the floor and breathe. Remember, exhale. Turn your hands forward, spread your fingers apart. Take the other foot back, come into whatever push-up plank position is working for you today. Remember, by pressing your fingertips into the floor, we engage more of our wrist and forearm muscles. I hope you're all feeling stronger as you practice this posture. Super important, working the heart. Release the knees, flatten the tops of your feet. Take your hips back towards your heels, stretching through the upper body as we flex the lower part. Release your forearms and elbows and stay nice and low. Keep your bum high. Slide everything forward. Align your fingertips with the edges of your shoulders and place your forehead on the mat. Elbows into your side body, press your forearms down to the floor. On an inhale, roll the invisible alley to lengthen your neck and start to lift up. Everybody's coming into baby cobra first. Then if you wish to come into the fuller expression, depending on how your lower back feels today, pressing up into Bhujangasana. Eyes rolling up towards Ajna, center of your forehead, seat of intuition. One more breath in, exhale, lengthen as you lower, curl your toes under, lift your hips up, walk your feet a few inches forward, bend your knees, press your belly to your thighs, your chest to your knees, align your ears with your inner arms and be sure you're pressing your fingertips into the floor. Inhaling in place, exhale. Press your sits bones towards the back of your mat and straighten your legs whatever amount you can and breathe. Lift that left leg up in the air and step your left foot forward and then right foot forward and let your upper body hang. Arms beside your ears, engage your thighs, pull your bellies in. Inhale, sweep up, feet apart for balance, reach up, look up. Arc back. Inhaling, stretch up. Exhale, forward fold. Bend your knees and sweep the arms out to the side, up and overhead. Exhale, hands to heart. Third round, how are we doing? Tip top Magoo. Inhale, exhale, hands in prayer. Step your feet apart. Arms up, reach up, look up, arc back. Inhale, feet come together, lift up out of your waist. Exhale, forward fold. Please let your heads hang here. And step your right leg back, drop the knee to the mat, bring your hands onto your left thigh. Come on up, hips and shoulders are aligned. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Be sure that you're pressing through your back heel. This is the anchor of your posture. And breathe. That means two parts, inhaling, exhaling. That's what respiration is. Turn your hands forward, spread your fingers apart. Take the other foot back. Coming into your push-up plank position, of course, this is cardio. It does work your heart. It's circulating the blood to all the muscles, organs, and glands required by your body. Release your knees, flatten the tops of your feet, leave your hands where they are, and take your hips back to your heels, stretching the body, the upper part. And now release your forearms and elbows as best you can to the floor. Stay nice and low. Keep your bum nice and high, and bring your chest and chin onto the mat. Keep coming as far forward as you need to. The more your spine releases tension and tightness and becomes more flexible, the higher your bum will be in the air. And now slide everything out behind you. Align your fingertips with the edges of your shoulders. Bring your elbows into your side body and press your forearms down to the floor. Roll the invisible alley with your nose till you're looking straight down at the floor. On an inhale, lift the head, neck, shoulders, chest off the floor. Of course, the diaphragm massages the heart. So when we're in this posture, the diaphragm is working, pressing up against the heart. One more breath in baby cobra. Exhale, lower down. Curl your toes under, lift your hips up, walk your feet a few inches forward, bend your knees, press your belly onto your thighs, press your chest towards your knees, press all 10 fingers into the mat, inhaling in place, exhale, take your sits bones back and press your heels towards the floor, and breathe. Step your left leg up in the air, look at your left hand. Swing that foot as far forward as you can, other leg forward. Please let your head hang in Uttanasana. Arms beside your ears, engage your thighs, pull your bellies in, inhale, sweep the arms in front, reaching up, feet apart for balance, arcing back. Inhaling, stretching up, exhale, forward fold, bend your knees, inhale, sweep the arms up and overhead. Exhale, bring your hands into Anjali Mudra. One more round if you can. If you're too pooped, then come into child's pose. Inhaling in place, exhale, hands in prayer. Step your feet apart, reaching up, looking up, arcing back. Inhale, feet back together. Lift up out of your waist. Exhale, forward fold, let your heads hang. Step your right leg back, drop your knee to the mat, and then lift your back knee off the floor, press through your heel. Inhale, sweep the arms up in front, turn your palms forward, spread your fingers apart, and take your front leg back. And come on into your push-up plank position. Press your heels back, reach through the crown of your head. Please give yourself a yogic hug by bringing your rib cage together, engaging and pulling your belly up towards your spine, and then release your knees, flatten the tops of your feet, take your hips back towards your heels, lengthening the upper body, stretching the heart chambers, and then release your forearms and elbows to the floor, slowly coming forward. Releasing chest and chin, bum stays in the air. This is excellent for people who are getting hunched over in their upper back to counteract that. A lot of that happens when the head pitches forward, it rounds the upper back. Not attractive. Now, slide everything back with your body flat on the floor.
Line your fingertips with the edges of your shoulders. Bring your elbows into your side body and press your forearms down to the floor. Notice how your shoulders move away from your ears and your shoulder blades down your back. Roll the invisible alley. Now you may wish to take your feet a little bit wider and roll your baby toe into the mat. On an inhale, without using your hands, lift your head, neck, shoulders, and chest off the floor. And then if you wish, pressing up into the fuller expression of Bhujangasana Cobra, stretching the heart. One more breath in, exhale, lengthen and lower. Bring your toes back towards one another, curl them under, lift your hips, walk your feet a couple of inches forward, and then press your belly on your thighs, press your chest towards your knees, pressing your fingertips into the floor, inhaling in place. Exhale, press your sits bones towards the back wall. So your ears are probably just grazing your inner arms. Lift your right leg up in the air, look at your right hand, swing that foot as far forward as you can, other leg forward. Please let your upper body hang, arms beside your ears. Pull your bellies in, engage your thighs, inhale, sweeping up, feet apart for balance, reach up, look up, arc back. Inhaling, stretch up, exhale, forward fold, bend your knees, inhale, sweep the arms up and overhead. Exhale, hands in prayer. Okay. Take a sip of water if you like. We're still going to remain standing and do a wee bit of a vinyasa. How are we doing? Everybody good? Your heart beating a little bit faster? Just a little bit, not too much, right? Okay, so come on up to the front of your mat. All right, we're going to start with Utkatasana, chair pose, inhaling. Now, sit back as if you were sitting in a chair, sweeping the arms up. Have a look down. Your knees should be behind your toes, so your weight is in your heels. Again, this is aerobically demanding. So when we practice aerobic, more aerobic type of exercise, we tend to do more exhaling. Exhale, forward fold, coming into Uttanasana. Inhale, come halfway up. Exhale, fingertips back to the floor. Step your right leg back and then sweep the arms up, coming into Warrior Two, Warrior Two. So your torso and your body are sideways to your mat. And then take your back arm, sweep it up and overhead, bring them back down onto the floor. So they're flat on the floor. Take your front foot back, curl over onto the tops of your feet, coming into upward facing dog. Upward facing dog, your thighs are off the floor. Curl your toes under and downward facing dog. And then walk your hands back towards your feet. Bend your knees, sit back in your chair. Come on back into Utkatasana. So look down at your feet. Your toes are in front of your knees. Exhale, forward fold, inhaling, come halfway up, and then walk your hands forward again. Roll over onto the tops of your feet, coming into upward facing dog. Curl the toes under, exhale, downward facing dog. And now step your right foot forward and then windmill your front arm up, coming into Warrior Two once again. Pardon my back. And windmill that top arm up and over, coming back into Downward Dog. Roll over onto the tops of your feet, coming into Upward Facing Dog. And then bring your knees to the floor. Take your knees the width of your mat. Bring your toes together. Flatten the tops of your feet. We're coming into our modified child's pose for some relaxation, allowing the heart to slow down. So remember, if your forehead is comfortable directly on the mat, good. If you need some height, fold your forearms one on top of the other. If you require more, you can make fists and stack them. So breathing into your side and back ribs. So this is getting the heart rate up. Yoga can be anything. It can be cardio. And that's exactly what we were doing. We were really working the heart here, getting the heart rate up. It's important. Inhaling, come on up, draw your knees in together. Now, if you have your block or cushion handy, we're going to do pigeon pose and do some stretching of the heart. I do have the mats now. I've bought extra ones for your knees. If you have knee issues, they're on the bench over there. So take your right foot forward, and you're going to bring your knee, your right knee towards the front of the mat, and then look behind you that your left leg is straight behind you. So this is where you may wish to put a block or cushion under that right hip. So tenting your fingers on the mat and lifting and stretching through the upper body. Ekapada Raja Kapotasana. So when you think about a pigeon, they're kind of barrel chested. Lifting and lengthening. Exhale, now walk your hands forward and just come down onto your forearms and elbows and see how that feels. And then if you wish to take it a little bit further, and that's only if you wish to, you can bring your chest onto your thighs, your forehead. Now, this is where, again, you may wish to add height for your forehead. Inhale, pressing up. Come back into this partial sphinx with your Ekapada Raja Kapotasana, your pigeon pose. And as you breathe in, breathing out, imagine water running all the way down the back of your body, all the way across your legs to your feet. One more breath in. And then come on up, bring your hands underneath your shoulders, take your block or cushion to the other side, curl your back toes under, press up. And come on into downward facing dog. And we're just going to walk the dog here a little bit because it's a pretty intense stretch. Please relax your neck. Don't hold your head up. Give it a shake if you're not sure. And just gently walk the dog by bending one leg and straightening the other. Releasing your hips. Relax your neck. Breathe. Be sure you're exhaling. Be sure you're releasing carbon dioxide. And I think everybody knows that the trees give off oxygen and then they receive our carbon dioxide. So trees are the lungs of the planet. I think I need to write Doug Ford and remind him not to cut down those dang trees at Ontario Place and make a spa that nobody can afford to go to. It's ridiculous. Anyway, blah, blah, blah. Okay, let's lift the left leg up in the air, look forward, and bring the left knee towards the front of the mat. And then look behind you that the other leg is straight out behind you. Again, you can prop up your hip with a cushion or a block, and you're free to stay in this position. Now, if this is too intense on your knees, of course, you may wish to roll over. Now, that kind of loses the integrity, but doesn't matter. You're still getting lots of benefits here. So be mindful, practice mindfully with awareness, respect, and compassion.
And then lifting the heart, lengthen through the front of the body. Powerful hip opener, powerful for the lower back. Often the lower back is rounded in that lumbar region, which causes all kinds of stress. This is brilliant for the lower back. One more breath in. Exhale, if you're able, release your forearms onto the floor, kind of like Sphinx pose. And this may be as far as your hips or thigh are going to let you go. Don't be a hero. But if you can and wish to, you can lower yourself down. And again, add some height for your forehead. Breathe into whichever part of your body is feeling the most tension, the most tightness. And come back into Sphinx and press up one more time to stretch the front of the body. Eyes open or closed, up to Ajna Chakra. So I was quite surprised when I read that 1/10 of our weight is our blood. The heart, basically about the size of two fists, a little more to the left, under the lungs, which is why the left lung is slightly smaller than the right lung to accommodate the space for the heart, the organ that never rests. And then remove whatever may be underneath your left hip, curl your right toes under and gently, carefully coming up. And let's walk the dog again, bending one leg, straightening the other, relax your neck, let the weight of your head, that 12 to 15 pounds, stretch out your cervical vertebra. Take advantage of being in this posture. Slowly, gently walking the dog. And then come on down onto your knees and come on over onto your back. Remember, take a sip of water anytime you feel the need. Now, with your knees bent and your feet flat on the floor, tuck your shoulder blades under. Tilt your chin towards the center of your chest. Now, for people who have a tendency towards high blood pressure, bridge pose is excellent for reducing blood pressure. I'm going to talk a little bit more about arteries. Okay, in a moment. So place your arms beside your body with your palms facing down. Press the small of your back into the floor and peel your spine off the floor. So arteries, of course, and the veins form an extensive network throughout the body. Not getting enough exercise, not being hydrated, and water is still the best form of hydration for the heart, the lungs, and the arteries. You want to keep the cells on the inside of the arteries moist, and you want to keep your arteries stretched. Otherwise, it results in hypertension, high blood pressure. The arteries are stiff, they're narrow. It just makes sense. So lifting up, let's bring arms underneath the body and do a little rocking from side to side and bring your shoulder blades together with your fingertips, your fingers clasped and your knuckles pointing towards your heels. Now, if your arms are not flat on the floor, please undo and bring the arms back to the side of the body because we're going to lower the torso onto the arms. Inhaling, lifting, pressing up. Exhaling, lower down. Inhaling, lifting the torso up. And then release the arms, and starting from the top of the vertebra, slowly bring your torso back down onto the mat and press the small of your back into the floor. And now take a block or a cushion. We're going to pretend we're doing legs up the wall, but we don't want to get into the harangue of moving around. So I want you to imagine by putting a cushion or a block underneath your sacrum and just lift your legs up. So this helps the veins releasing the valves of the veins to allow the ease of blood flow that may have pooled in the base of the spine or in the ankles to return to the heart. So obviously there's carbon dioxide, and that's just a naturally occurring substance in the body from respiration, from cellular metabolism. But we want it to come back to the heart, and then that carbon dioxide is released to the lungs, and then you exhale, and off it goes. So obviously, it's a bit complicated, but the body does all this for us, and all we have to do is breathe, hydrate, exercise. By practicing yoga, you're managing your mind and body stress, tension. Eating the best diet you can, we're going to talk about this. Now, the name of the spiritual heart, Anahata, which is not the same as the physical heart. Anahata is the chakra of the seven major chakras that joins the three lower chakras, the lower nature, with the three chakras above the heart, which is considered to be the higher nature. But that's a whole other story. Focusing just at the heart center, the color is green. So this is a beautiful time of year because everything's green. And when you see green, when you eat green food, so obviously leafy green vegetables, excellent for the heart. I think most of us know what heart healthy foods are. Fatty fishes, omega-3 oils, chia seeds, hemp, flax, walnuts and almonds. Now almonds roasted offer a little more heart protection than just raw almonds. They're also a little tastier. And of course, when it comes to fish, salmon, mackerel, sardines, I just can't seem to acquire a taste for sardines, but I do take my omega-3s every single day. And then let's lower the legs back down onto the mat and remove whatever is underneath your sacrum and stretch your legs out in front. And bring your arms beside your body with your palms facing up in the open and receiving position. And just take a moment to let the body absorb the benefits of your actions, your performance, your practice. Always remember to make your exhalation at least as long and preferably longer than your inhalation. This is a form of letting go, but in terms of today's class, it's releasing carbon dioxide. When we're active, the body produces more carbon dioxide. When we eat food, the body, the cellular metabolism produces waste. And again, we want to exhale that waste out. And the reason we need to hydrate is because just breathing, just respiration, releases some of the fluid in our body. Sweating, whether we think we are or not, all kinds of moisture is leaving our cells. Alrighty, draw your knees up into your chest, place your hands underneath the backs of your knees, or roll over onto your side, whichever feels best, or roll up and come on over onto your bellies for a little more cardio. All right, placing your forehead on the floor. First of all, we'll do a little more stretching again. Place your elbows underneath your shoulders and your forearms straight out in front, coming into Sphinx pose. Let there be a natural curve in the back of your neck, rounding up over your skull with your eyes, once again, open or closed, looking up at Ajna Chakra. Shoulders away from your ears. Obviously, there's a lot of sinking into the body. We kind of sink into our waist, we sink into our shoulders, sinking into our hips. So think about lengthening, stretching through the hip area, all the way up the spine, right up to the crown of your heads. Leaving your hands where they are. Let's try to straighten the arms. Now you can take your hands a little wider apart if you need to, and if this isn't good for your lower back, then release your forearms and elbows right back down to the floor. Make sure your elbows, again, right under your shoulders. So modified cobra. One more breath in. And come on all the way down. Bring your arms beside your body with your palms facing up and your forehead flat on the floor. Pressing your hips and pelvis into the mat, roll an invisible alley with your nose to lengthen your neck. On an inhale, lifting your head, neck, shoulders, arms, feet, and legs coming off the floor into locust pose, salabhasana. All back bends. Activate the cardiovascular system. Working against gravity. And again, a myriad of benefits to locust pose, salabhasana. It stimulates and releases toxins and waste from reproductive organs and glands, digestive organs and glands. Of course, it's strengthening all the muscles on the backside of your body, which don't get as much work as the front. So one more breath in, inhale, lift, exhale, come on all the way down. Turn your head to the right, big toes touch, heels splay out, arms beside your body with your palms facing up. And bring your head back to the center. Let's up the ante a little bit and take the arms straight out in front. Roll the invisible alley with your nose. Press your hips and pelvis into the floor. On an inhale, lift the arms, lift the legs.
Keep breathing, which I'm sure you are. And one more breath in and lift a little higher. And then exhale, bring the arms back beside the body, palms facing up. Turn your head to the opposite side. Big toes touch and heels splay out.
Just in case anybody watching Zoom, I'm just going to close the door.
Bringing the hands under the shoulder, the head back to the center. Inhale, coming up, and come on over onto your backs once again.
And draw the knees up into the chest and do a little rocking from side to side, or make some circles on your lower back. We'll stretch it out now. After we do a little massaging, extend the left leg down in front and keep the right knee bent. Interlock your fingers 2 inches below the kneecap and pull it in towards your chest. Let's mobilize the ankle joint, those five big bones, stretching the front of the foot, flexing and pointing. With your left hand on the outside of your right knee, draw it across your body and extend the right arm out to the right side. Remember, you want to feel something here in your glutes, your hip. Not too much, not too little, but if you're not feeling anything, draw the knee a little bit higher up towards your opposing shoulder. And breathe into this area. Maybe it's your armpit, your pectorals, maybe you've been busy gardening. Good deep inhaling and deep exhaling. The holding gives the body a chance and the time it needs to release whatever it is that we may have put into it, whether it was physical, mental, emotional, tension or stress. We can't avoid stress, but we must learn to manage it. It's harmful to body and mind. Notice whether the body has released some of the tightness. Of course, we're also releasing the muscular work that we just imposed upon the lower back in our back bends. Inhale, bring the knee back to center. Draw the knee once more into the chest. And then as you begin to straighten the leg, you're not actually going to really straighten it, but straighten it a little bit and reach up towards your ankle. Inhaling in place, exhale, pull the leg towards you as you lift your head, neck, and shoulders towards your knee or your shin. And release that leg all the way back down slowly, working your hip flexors, your quadriceps, and your lower abdominal muscles. Lifting your shoulder blades up and tucking them under your heart. Inhaling in place. Exhale, draw the left knee up. Interlock your fingers 2 inches below the knee and let's mobilize the ankle joint on the left side, pointing and flexing, making circles. And with your right hand on the outside of your left knee, draw it across your body and extend your left arm out to the left side. So beautiful twist, stretch for the spine. Getting into a little bit more stretching here for the heart. Remember, the heart is more to the left, underneath the left lung. So again, with your hand on the outside top of your left knee, you're maintaining a modicum of pressure to help release tightness and tension in your IT band, your hips, your glutes, or again, maybe your pectoral muscles. These are the two muscles that go from the chest to the armpit. Inhaling, bringing the knee back to center. Once again, interlock the fingers 2 inches below the knee, and then reach your hands up towards your ankle, interlocking your fingers behind your Achilles tendon, perhaps your calf, maybe it's the back of your knee, but try to be somewhere between the back of the knee and the ankle, and then straightening the leg somewhat without hyperextending the knee here. Inhale in place, exhale, pull that leg towards you as you draw your nose to your knee or your chin to your shin, depending on the length of your torso, your leg. One more breath in. Exhale, release it, lengthen it, arms beside your body, and slowly lower a nice long leg back down, slowly beside the other leg. Bring your heels together, let your feet splay out. Once again, tuck your shoulder blades under your heart. Point your chin towards the center of your chest. Turn your palms up in the open and receiving position and just let your body be soft and heavy. Letting go fully and completely. Just gathering our strength before we come back up for a couple of more standing postures to stretch and strengthen the heart. So 2/3 of the earth is covered in water, about 60% of our body, and about 70% of our hearts, all water. So if you're dehydrated, you're not drinking 6 to 8 glasses of water a day, and as it warms up, we need to drink more. More water, or your health, your heart, your veins, your arteries, your lungs, they are all compromised if you are dehydrated. And that's a big compromise. So if you find yourself weary, fatigued, maybe even a little headachy, it just could be dehydration. All right. Draw the knees up in towards the chest or roll over onto your side, rocking up. Come on over onto all fours. And curl the toes under, walk your hands back, and just let your upper body hang, resting your upper body on your thighs, let your head hang, pressing the soles of your feet into the floor, slowly roll up, keeping your chin tucked into your chest, your arms hanging, and let your head be the last thing to come up. Okay, so some of you may wish to have some added height at the front of your mat. We're going to practice Trikonasana and Ardhachandrasana, so half moon pose. How's everybody doing? Feeling good? A little tired? That's okay. You'll get a rest in a few minutes. All right. Coming up to the fronts of your mat, step your right leg back, one leg length. Have your front foot pointing 90 degrees straight and your back foot about 60 degrees pointing forward. And of course, the heel of your front foot creates that straight line through the arch of your back foot. Now your legs are going to stay straight. Don't bend your front leg. Inhale, sweep the arms up to the side, Trikonasana. Reach over your front toes. Reach, 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 reach. When you can't reach any further, just let that front arm hinge organically in front of your front leg inside and reach the other arm up, stretching the heart, reaching up. So your arm goes straight up, Philip, straight up to the sky. Yep. All right. Now you could look down, lower that top arm onto your hip. Now you can bend your front leg and transfer your weight onto your front leg and bringing your back foot closer, tent your fingers either on the floor or on a block, just in front of and outside of your front foot, and reaching your back leg so that it's 90 degree angle to the standing leg, reaching your top arm up, or you can keep your hand on your hip. Now balance, strength, and a little bit of flexibility here. And then step that back leg back onto your mat. And I want you to come back into triangle pose. So reaching, top arm straight up, looking up potentially. Inhale, come on up. And then let's pivot on our feet to do the other side. So again, get your alignment just right. Your front foot's 90 degrees, your back foot about 60 degrees, pointing somewhat forward. Sweep the arms up to shoulder height, lower your shoulders, lengthen your neck. Make sure you're lifting up out of your waist, you're not sinking into your hips, and then reach forward until you can't reach any further, and then just hinge, letting the front arm fall inside of the front leg and reaching the other arm straight up. So your front arm is inside of your front leg. Both your palms should be facing the direction of your nose. Now, lower your back arm onto your back hip. Bend your front leg. Scooch your back leg up. Transfer your weight onto your front foot. Fingertips tented on the floor. Lifting your top arm up. And if you really want to go for it, lift your bottom hand off the floor too. So you're just balancing on your bottom leg, but don't try to do too much here. Stepping your back leg back, come right back into Trikonasana, reaching your top arm up. Inhale, come on into your five-pointed star and turn your feet both outwards on your mats. Five-pointed star, your feet are turned out. Please widen your feet a lot, at least 3 feet, if not four. Now exhale, forward fold, just halfway, tabletop your spine, tent your fingers on the floor. Inhale, sweep the left arm up, reaching up, stretching up, maybe looking up, or keeping your eyes closed. Exhale, float it down. Inhale, sweep the other arm up, reaching up, stretching up. Exhale, float it down. Let's lunge over to the left, bringing your bum as close to your heel as you can. Inhaling up and over to the other side. Inhale back to center, walk your feet in. And then if you wish to get an eye pillow, grab a tissue, they're over there, and you can grab, there's half tissue and the eye pads for our final shavasana. And flat out and relaxing. Good work, everybody. Make yourself as comfortable as possible. Palms are facing up in the open and receiving position. Separate the biting surfaces of the teeth. Relax the jaw. So we covered the five yamas in the last 5 weeks, which were avoiding violence, lying, stealing, wasting energy, and possessiveness. So next we're on to the five niyamas. And this is part of Ashtanga yoga, which means eight limbs. So the yamas and the niyamas represent the two bottom limbs of the ladder. So the first niyama is asking us to embrace cleanliness, sauka or saucha. And when we think about cleanliness, we want to think about inside and out. So yeah, of course, keeping some order helps to create a sense of calm. We, of course, practice physical hygiene, brushing our teeth, washing our hair, bathing. But there's also mental hygiene. So what goes into our minds? And even how our minds are interpreting what's going on is the interpretation healthy or unhealthy? Is it constructive or is it counterproductive? And the other way we can practice cleanliness is simplifying as much as possible, even though we live at a time that is quite complicated. How is it that we can simplify things? And sometimes it's just getting up and walking away to stop and drop, whether it's your backyard, your balcony, take a walk, unplug, basically. To breathe fully and completely and let go of the detritus, let go of what really isn't going to matter in 5 seconds, 5 months, or 5 years. Inhaling the life force, long, full, and deep. And deep exhaling. Inhaling. And exhaling. Inhaling. Opening your mouth to exhale, letting it all go. How can we simplify life? The goal is to enjoy life. And how can we enjoy it if we're not at peace, if we're stressed out? Yoga is offering us the simplest of tools, if only we can remember when the stress is building, to breathe, to ground yourself, and ask yourself, is it really worth it to get stressed out and messed up over a lot of the things that we stress out about? Just ask yourself, the more you practice, the less you will have to practice. It will just become automatic and innate. Breathing in and letting go. Stretch your arms over behind your heads. Reach and stretch, point feet far, flex and point, and drop your arms down by your side. Whenever you're ready, roll over onto your side. Bending your knees, you can use your bottom arm as a pillow if you want to spend a moment there. Be kind to yourself. And when you're ready, press yourself back up. And this is a Native American proverb. Listen to the wind, it talks. Listen to the silence, it speaks. And listen to your heart. It knows. Have a beautiful day. Namaste. Oh, and the one food that I didn't mention.